I've been looking forward to doing this for a while. The worst Call of Duty maps throughout history. Starting at COD 4, because that's when I feel like the love for the game kind of blew up. And when I started playing it myself, I switched over from Halo and started playing more COD and COD 4. So, yeah, we're going to start there. Now, if you enjoy the video, like and subscribe. Would love to have you back. Also, I'm going to need some of your comments. You might disagree with some of these, but there's a few games that I didn't play a lot of, and I had to ask for some advice on, and we'll see if you guys agree with the overall votes that we had for it. All right? This is coming from someone who mainly plays Search and Destroy. A lot of times, the Respawn players agree, though. I've learned that over time. Let me hit play on this so I can kind of narrate through it. We're starting off with Call of Duty 4, and in COD 4, there was Wet Work. Wet Work was a giant boat map. I don't have audio on this clip because there was copyright music being played. I do have audio on most of these, but it was a giant boat, and it was basically a huge straight line. Even though there is technically a left and right lane on the map and a middle lane, it really didn't exist because the lanes were like all jumbled together. They weren't really separated apart for the most part. And you end up just dying to a ton of grenades on this map. 3x frags, just aiming straight down, whipping them over. You would get, I don't know, 10, 15 kills a game. It was absurd. And that was honestly a problem in COD 4 as a whole. 3x frags and frag grenades being just too damn good. This map easily was one of the worst maps in the game. Not only was it hard to see people because it was a night map, it was also very campy with snipers who would sit up on the top and just never move. And on top of it, you would also have this constant, you don't hear it in the video right now, but constant rain sound effect because it's in the rain. So Wet Work was COD 4's worst map. People did not like it. It was hard to move around on, and it was just a giant standoff typically of holding left trigger. Moving into World at War. World at War was Downfall. You guys might not even remember this map. It was huge. It was huge in Respawn. It was huge in Search and Destroy. It was just a big ass map all around. And on top of it, it also, I think, had tanks. I'm pretty sure tanks spawned on this map. I think they spawned on CeeLo. They spawned on Roundhouse. They spawned on Outskirts, I believe, as well. This was the main reason I started playing Search and Destroy. I loved Search, but I hated tanks. I hated vehicles in Call of Duty. Didn't like it at all. It was annoying to deal with. Absolutely despised it. And I was like, oh, well, looks like Search doesn't have vehicles, and I like Search already. I'm just going to play Search. And that was pretty much where it all started, and I stuck with it for the last 16 years. But Downfall was a bad map. It was not good. It was very wide open. There was not a lot of places to go. And if you did want to get into a spot where you were kind of safe, it was just a super campy mess. You basically just sat in corners, and it was horrible. Modern Warfare 2 had some bad maps. As you guys have seen now, Wasteland had to take the cake. Derail was obviously not very good. A lot of people didn't like Rundown either, but Wasteland was unanimously hated by everybody. Not only because there was very poor vision on the map, but because spawn tubes absolutely annihilated it. And on top of that, if you got a streak on this map like a Harrier, it was basically a guaranteed nuke. So if you were trying to go for a really fast nuke, I think Wasteland had the fastest nuke in the game for the original Modern Warfare 2. It took somewhere around 48 seconds. That's quick, but remember back in Modern Warfare 2, streaks or kills with streaks would apply to your nuke. So you would go for a spawn tube, you'd kill the whole team essentially right away. You would get a Harrier, you'd call the Harrier in. It would give you your AC-130, you use the AC-130, you get the nuke. It would take very little time at all. Wasteland was horrible, we didn't like it, and let's forget about it until, of course, later in this video. Because it's coming back with a vengeance. Moving past Modern Warfare 2, you guys might even know this map. This is a DLC map of Black Ops 1. It was called Kowloon. Just listen. That might have rang a bell. Kowloon was an annoying map because, again, nighttime-ish dusk map with rain. You're going to notice a trend on some of these maps chosen. And at the start of every game, you'd have a airplane fly over you louder than all... I don't know why. Why would you do that? It was so loud. It sucks. So Kowloon was a pretty despised map back in BO1. It was a DLC map, though, so you didn't really have to deal with it for most of the game. In terms of how the map was laid out, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't good. It was pretty campy was the problem. It wasn't that like you had really, really bad routes. It was just that on every route you took, you would probably get camped out on. And then combined with the low visibility nighttime, the annoying sound of rain, that stupid airplane, which by the way would fly over you every round of search and destroy, not just once a game, every round. It was annoying. It was annoying and nobody liked it. Black Ops 1 otherwise though had a lot of good maps in it. I was looking through a lot of them and I was like, dude, I don't really see when that sits out. It's like, this sucks. And then I saw Kowloon and was like, dude, I remember that one. And so yeah, I had to pick it. Kowloon was the worst map of BO1. I liked BO1 as a game. A lot of people chose to go back and play Modern Warfare 2 during this time. People didn't really like older Call of Duty games. World at War, Black Ops 1. BO2 was a little futuristic. They did like that one. After BO1 was Modern Warfare 3. Downturn was the worst map of Modern Warfare 3. Everyone hated this map. And although you're watching footage that I could find in decent quality, this guy stayed on the top street in the house. Downturn was disliked because it was very campy up on the top street and in the house. But also, if you went down below into the subway system, you couldn't see shit. It was so dark. It was campier than hell. This map sucked. And at the same time, if you ever got a streak on it, it would never hit anybody because they would all somehow be inside. So there was tons of camping spots, tons of head glitching spots. At the same time, if you went out in the open for a second, someone would usually kill you because it was very snipe heavy down the big lanes. But this was a bad map, man. It was a bad map. It was funny because when I talked about Modern Warfare 3 and bad maps, Slade brought this map up and he didn't know the name of it. And I was like, that was Downturn. Downturn sucked. It was not good in any game mode, unfortunately. And yeah, it could have been better without this map. But Modern Warfare 3 as a game was pretty good overall. I thought it was a little bit ruined with Recon Pro and Sitrep Pro. You might not have had those big of issues in Respawn, but in Search, they were bad. In Respawn, I could see Sitrep Pro being bad, but probably not Recon Pro. So this game ended up in the top 3, maybe top 4 COD games for me of all time, but it was not near number 1 or number 2. BO2 had to be number 1, and you'll see the worst map for that right now. Slums. Even though BO2 had a lot of good maps, Slums was really bad for Search and Destroy because it was so unfair how close the defense team would spawn to the middle. And you could get to the middle before offense, and when you do that, it basically locked off the whole map, so you couldn't really play. I'm guessing it plays relatively similarly in other objective-based game modes. I'm not sure how Team Deathmatch plays on Slums, if people liked it or disliked it, if you got spawn trapped too much. But BO2 was actually just one of the best games, the best Call of Duty game ever made, but just one of the best games for maps overall. You had maps like Standoff, you had maps like Raid that were even brought back into Cold War, maps that were hijacked, I mean Express, maps that were so good and very linear and fair for both offense and defense, that it was just a wildly successful game. It had ranked play on release. It had customizable player cards. It had your combat record, which you could see public combat records. You had lobby leaderboards. You had map voting, which is surprising that was taken away. You had red dots on the minimap. This game had and did relatively everything right. The only complaint I would have of BO2, it had dead silence as a perk, was that it had awareness as a perk as well that kind of countered the dead silence. Only problem. Moving on to Call of Duty Ghosts. This was one of the worst games ever made to me. And this is, in my opinion, the worst map ever made in any Call of Duty game since the dawn of time. Stonehaven. This map, as you can tell, is absolutely enormous. This map was so big that when you played it on console and you would aim across it with a sniper, you would actually lose frame rate. You would go from a 60 FPS game down to like a 30 FPS game, and it made it so it was very difficult to snipe at distances, which was the entire map itself. Even if you were to move around on this map, you would probably get sniped at some point, or you would get camped out because once you got near the castle, it was relatively campy. I left this up because I cannot believe this was actually a map in COD. This, I mean, dude, Ghost had a lot of bad maps. The game itself was not good. It was very linear with the map creation. And what I mean by that is that even though the lanes, there had three lane maps, you would get to a point where you couldn't go any further. And the kill time in Ghosts was probably the fastest it's ever been in the franchise, along with COD 4. And so because you die faster, and how this is a problem in every COD, the faster you die, the more people camp. And so when you would rush on these maps, you would push forward, they would get to certain points where the head glitch would be, and people would just never go further. Because they knew if they were, or if they did, they would get head glitched back, and they would have no chance to win the gunfight because you died so fast. Instantly. It was insanely quick. Sniping was good in this game. It did have very fast ADS and very fast kill time, but because the kill time was so fast with other weapons, it didn't stick out that much. It didn't. It's unfortunate, though, because Ghost could have been pretty decent. Also, as you can see from this gameplay, thermals were used on everything. Used thermal sniper, thermal LMG, thermal Remington, thermal everything. It was a little annoying. Ghosts, yeah, a lot of the competitive guys liked this game, I guess because they banned a lot of the stuff that was stupid in pubs, but there was a lot of dumb crap in pubs, and it made the game awful. Awful in search, and I would consider awful in respawn as well. So, that was Call of Duty Ghosts, and that was the worst map in COD ever made, Stonehaven. Couldn't even function properly at the correct frame rate if you looked across it. It was so large. I hope to God they never do that again. We'll see. We'll see. There was actually an equally large map in World at War called, was it CeeLo? Maybe CeeLo? But you never spawned on the backside of it in search. You never looked across the full map, so you didn't have that frame rate problem. Past Call of Duty Ghosts, we had Advanced Warfare. And this is the Instinct in Advanced Warfare. This map was annoying because it was just a big hill, and if you were stuck on the bottom of it, you kind of got picked off nonstop, along with the fact that it was very head glitchy on the stairwell and kind of campy when it came to the forest side, is the left side of the map. What is that? The west side? West side of it. You kind of blend in. Advanced Warfare really didn't have a lot of terrible maps, but it didn't have a lot of good maps either. It was kind of a lot of B-tier, C-tier maps. Not a lot stuck out as A-tier, but they weren't horrible to the point where you would call them, like, Stonehaven level. So, Instinct was AW's worst map. This game was plagued mainly with, you know, the supply drops, the pay-to-win system, having the Obsidian Steed, Bal, or the Bal Inferno, or the HBRE3 Insanity, and you would just have a disadvantage. Those people could kill you faster, and that was lame. And, yeah, I'm glad that we don't have those that problem anymore. I'm glad that's gone. Past, what was it? Advanced Warfare. Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3's DLC map, Rupture, comes in at number one as the worst map. You might recognize it because of the mechs on it. This was the last DLC of BO3, so maybe you didn't play the full life cycle and you didn't experience this. That's totally fine. Congratulations, you won. This map fucking sucked. The mechs were annoying. And yes, by the way, the mechs were in Search and Destroy, at least from what I remember, because I don't play much respawn and I remember having to deal with the mechs. Ugh, this map was not good. It was not good. But there is another map. There's a runner-up in Black Ops 3 that was in the game from launch, because I know a lot of people probably didn't last until the final DLC of the game. And so the runner-up for the Black Ops 3, and BO3 had a lot of good maps in it. A lot of maps I liked, even DLC maps like Micro or Splash or, you know, what was it? The skateboard map. Is it Grid? I don't remember that. I don't think it's that. But the few bad ones, this one was it, and then Exodus was the runner-up for Black Ops 3. And I have a little bit of gameplay of Exodus as well to jog your memory, because I feel like if you don't see the gameplay, you might not remember the map. There's a lot of maps we've played over time, right? Exodus wasn't that bad of a map, except for the outside. The outside, this is the inside middle. This isn't too bad. It was a little shotgun heavy, which, you know, in BO3, that was the brekkie, and it was pretty annoying as a shotgun, I agree. The outside of the map was very head glitchy and campy, though. So you kind of had to play the middle, in my opinion, if you were trying to be successful. So, I don't know. I don't think Exodus was that bad, but it wasn't great. And it was definitely dominated by brekkies and the akimbo, was it Marshalls, the pistol shotguns? It was not fun. The outer edge of the map was just head glitch city and very boring, and it was hard to grenade people off those head glitches. I struggled a lot with that. So, moving past BO3, though, we're getting into Infinite Warfare. This is a map I need your guys' help with. I asked some friends and on Twitter. I did not play Infinite Warfare. It's the first Call of Duty I never hit max prestige in. I thought it was the worst game, and I think it's well voted at this point from the community based on sales numbers that it was the worst game they've ever made. Infinite Warfare Grounded is what people said was the worst map in Infinite Warfare. They said IW, despite it not being a good game, it didn't have the worst maps, which that's good, I guess, a slight uptick. But everything else, about Infinite Warfare was bad. I didn't like the health bars above heads. I didn't like the kill times. I didn't like the weapons. I didn't like the audio. I didn't like most of this game. Didn't like the abilities. You turn to a freaking rabid dog. I hated Infinite Warfare. I did. And again, the game sales kind of back this up, and I think the general census of the community, it is and was the worst Call of Duty ever made. So, at least I was kind of with the times back then. I'm not sure if I still have the same opinion as other people nowadays, based off my recent tweets. I think that Cold War was not a great game, and people said it was great. I disagree. I think it was horrible, and we're going to talk about that later. Going past Infinite Warfare, World War II. Did not like this game that much, mainly because it was an old game. Gustav Cannon was the most hated map in World War II. Definitely disliked in every mode. It was not liked in Search. It was not liked in Respawn. It was hated. Gustav Cannon was giant open map. You get sniped on it nonstop. It was hard to push up on. If you could camp, you'd camp on top of the big part and you'd snipe as well. It was annoying. And World War II, in general, people just don't like older Call of Duty games. Going through the history of COD, people didn't like World at War. They went back and played COD 4. They didn't like BO1. They went back and played Modern Warfare 2. They finally liked BO2. But for years and years, and you look at World War II, people didn't like World War II that much. They went back and played BO3, me included, I think, after a while. You looked at Cold War. People didn't like Cold War. They went back and played Modern Warfare 19. Vanguard, same thing. People don't like older Call of Duty games. They just don't. They prefer to play more modern era stuff or even a little futuristic. But moving past World War II, we go into the future with Black Ops 4. And I didn't play much BO4 because I was on Fortnite at the time. But BO4, people voted for Arsenal Sandstorm. And I can totally understand why, looking at this footage. The guy's using the thermal, and you can't see jack squat outside. This looks like a terrible map. Why the hell? I don't know how you could have possibly taken Arsenal, which is a map that was already in the game, added a giant sandstorm to it, and thought, yeah, this was an improvement. My only guess is they Arsenal maybe suffered from too many snipers, and they were like, oh, well, let's limit their visibility by making it so they can't see across the whole map. Yeah, it didn't work. I think it still looks like shit. It looks bad. Arsenal Sandstorm, I totally understand why you guys would have hated this. I would hate this too. A lot of the maps people voted for were maps that were already in the game and had slight effects or changes to them. Arsenal was one of those, and there's a few runner-ups for Black Ops 4 because there were quite a few votes for these maps as well. Getting past Arsenal Sandstorm, there was Hacienda Night. And I was like, well, I actually like night maps if they're done correctly. This was not done correctly. When you walk into rooms and you can't see anything because it's too dark, that's not done correctly. I do not like that. When I think of nighttime mode maps, the first one I ever played, well, Night and Day, was Macon in World at War. And that was a decent version of Night and Day. It wasn't so dark you wouldn't see anything, but it was also dark enough that you could tell it was like in a dusk nighttime-ish map. Now, there's another nighttime map coming up that was also extremely well hated. But before we get to it, there is a third map for BO4 that people voted for a lot, which I probably would have liked. I'm going to be honest. This last map, I enjoy trolling a little bit with water maps, so I probably would have liked it, but it was Flooded Jungle. I like hiding under the water and shooting people because it gets reactions and it pisses people off, and I think that's funny. But if you're not trying to go for that kind of content, it is annoying. If you're trying to play maps like this, or you're trying to play maps like, what was the parking garage map in Ghosts, or perhaps even Paleo's Lighthouse in, was it Modern Warfare? That was MW2? Yeah, MW2. And you're trying to play those seriously, you're going to have a bad time. You cannot take these maps serious. They're not serious maps. They're trolley maps, gimmicky as hell. And unfortunately, sometimes the gimmick doesn't go off well and everybody hates it, like the Sandstorm. I probably would have liked trolling with the water a little bit. That being said, I most likely would not have voted for this map all the time or a lot of the time, because it's just, you know, even though you can come out of water and you can hide in the water, whenever you enter or exit water, you do make noise and you get sound. You get heard for doing it and killed all the time. It's annoying. So, Arsenal Sandstorm, Hacienda Twilight, or Flooded Jungle. Which was the worst for BO4? Again, I didn't play a lot of BO4. I was on Fortnite at the time. Let me know. You tell me. Modern Warfare 19, I think we all know. Ashir Cave, otherwise known as Ass Hair Cave. This map sucked. This map sucked. We did not like this map. It was very hard to visibly see people, even outside, because of kind of the dusky desert overlay of the map. And then when you're in the tunnel, it was even darker and harder to spot people. On top of it, both bomb sites were spawned next to defense. And even further to annoy you is that the head glitches were absurdly good on this map. And so when people head glitched against you, you couldn't really pick them off of it. This map, I almost always had a thermal HDR, and I would throw smoke grenades and I would one-way them through the smoke with a thermal, because it was the only way that you could actually knock them off the lane and then take control of it. But there's a runner-up. Besides the sheer cave, it was Euphrates Bridge. I think it's pronounced Euphrates. Yeah. I don't remember this being a search map. Honestly, I don't remember it being a search map, but it sucked. I did play it a few times when I was playing Respawn. Maybe we just never got it much in search, or we left if we got it. But this map was horrible. I mean, yeah, I agree. This map was bad. I hated it when I played Respawn. The people would hide up on the bridge, or they would hide back in the houses, or they would hide on head glitches. Almost always was just hiding and sniping. And again, maps that play like that aren't fun. It's just not fun to deal with snipers that are camping that you can't challenge because they one-shot you the second you peek. It's boring. It sucks. And funny enough, the other bridge map that I could think of was in World at War. It also sucked. It wasn't the worst map in World at War, but it did suck. Going past it, though, finally into Cold War. Satellite. Satellite was a shit map. Completely open. Basically no cover. Absolutely no rush routes whatsoever in search on this map, really, besides down the middle lane. It was ass. This map was balls. This game, in my opinion, was balls. They did not balance snipers. It ruined the game. It ruined the game. And people are like, oh, maybe you're just bad. I showed my KD. I pulled up my stats recently. I have a 4.7 KD with the Tundra in this game. 4.7. And it's my most used weapon. And the problem was, when you played Search, at least, I don't play a lot of Respawn, so if maybe it was better in Respawn. But in Search, if you wanted to use anything that wasn't a sniper, you had to overkill it with a sniper to open up the lane. So, I hated Cold War. Vanguard, though, also wasn't well-liked. And Numa Numa was probably the worst map of Vanguard. This map was very campy as well, very head glitchy. It did have some lanes, but because the lanes were very head glitchy, you couldn't move up the lane very well. You basically, if you moved, you died. It sucked. Unfortunately, Vanguard to me was better than Cold War, mainly because Vanguard was the best World War II game they've ever given us. There were a lot of attachments. There were a lot of guns. Was everything balanced properly and correctly? No. No. But it's the best World War II game that we ever had. They gave you in-depth stats to those weapons. If you were looking for a game, like for a World War II game, I think this is what you'd be looking for nowadays. I think the aesthetic of the game worked out really well. It was definitely better than World War II. So, Modern Warfare 2022, Santa Cena Border Crossing. This map, I mean, it's up there. It's up there for absolute utter trash. Everyone hated this on Respawn. They hated it in Search. They made a change to make it so the cars wouldn't blow up, and it still didn't really fix the map. It was still complete dick. We did not like Border Crossing. People hated this map. It was actually removed from the game for a short time, and that was great. It would have been fine if they kept it out forever. Didn't matter. We hated it. But even though we hated Border Crossing, and everyone would leave whenever it was voted for, whenever it would pop up, because you couldn't vote for the map in this game, I think. Or maybe it just got voted in sometimes by accident. There was another map that people also hated. Black Gold. DLC map, nighttime map, and this would also clear out lobbies. The second Border Crossing or Black Gold would show up as the map to play, everybody would leave nonstop. Nonstop. Leave, join, leave, join, leave, join. It was crazy. And yeah, I don't blame them. This map could be fun to troll on a little bit here and there, but for the most part, it was shit. It was a lot larger than it needed to be. It was very campy. You couldn't aim your gun down, like it would only go into tack stance if you wanted to try to shoot, unless you had a laser, I think, or there was some way to get around it. I forget though. Maybe it was a flashlight. But the map was bad and nobody wanted to play it. So that was fine with most of us. We kind of all just agreed that no one would ever play it. And if we got that map, we'd leave. It was good. Black Gold though, last but not least, Modern Warfare 2023. The only map to make the list twice is Wasteland again. This map, even though it is 15 years later, still fucking sucks. And they actually improved upon some of the other maps in the game, like Rundown or Derail, or, you know, some of these larger maps, they made Derail more visible. You could see better on it. There wasn't as much like weird snow mist in the air. And they made Wasteland a little bit more clear as well. But that didn't matter. Wasteland in this game was as ass it was before, and no one likes it at all. It's not fun to play on. Even though you could take away the spawn tubes, you could take away the thermal snipers as a little bit, it was bad. Wasn't a good map. And so it makes the list twice. Funny as that is. And I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed the worst maps. I'm sure most of these are on the money. Most of them. If you think I got some wrong, though, feel free to comment. And especially for BO4 and Infinite Warfare. I did not play those games much. I am totally open to hearing your opinion on that one. I totally get the BO4 complaints, though. Those three, I think those are probably got to be the worst. The Infinite Warfare one of Grounded, not so sure on. But like I said, if you enjoyed, like, subscribe. We'd love to have you back. Thanks for watching, and until next time.